present to you Jesus. He is the Alpha and Omega. Yesterday, the Lord visited us with the fear of the Lord, my God. And he has been good to us. Bible says, weeping may endure for the night, but joy coming in the morning. Don't feel weary in the things of God. Sometimes you encourage yourself in the word of God. It's only the word of God that will help you to soar like eagle. This morning, I bring you greetings from the Elohim, that I am God, the God who does things marvelously. And I said, may God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit visit you in the name of Jesus. This morning, the Lord have laid a word in my spirit to share with you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I said, the Lord have laid a word in my spirit to share with you. My God. Whatever you are, anything that you are doing, do it well. Because God knows you by your name. Hallelujah. This morning I present to you, build an altar for God. Mandolo bosito. Hallelujah. And as you build an altar for God, that altar will speak for you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. As you build an altar for God, that altar will speak for you, for your children, for your generation, for your wife, for your family, for your ministry, for your life. I said that altar that you build will speak for you. My God, let me tell you something. One thing I want you to know, let us build an altar of peace. Bible says Job remember his children and he went unto the Lord and he always built an altar for his children. The Lord didn't let your hand, enemy hand, touch my children. Let us build an altar for the Lord. Bible says, turn it to me in the book of Genesis chapter 22 verse 8. Listen to the word of God. Bible says that there was a man called Abraham. My God. This man's name was Abraham before, and God chose him from his nation, chose him from Egypt, and had his name Abraham. Bible says that he went through pain because his wife's name was Sarah, and Bible said they cannot bear, my God. They were barren, yet they can't see the fruitful of how God chose them. And Bible said day by day, God have covenant with Abraham. And he said, Lord, because of my covenant, 1 year by this time, as I return, something will happen into your life. And Bible says, God looked unto his word and he performed his word. My God, listen to this man. And Bible says that because his word never failed, he sent his word to see to it that he has accomplished a mission, and he came back. And Bible says Abraham, and God spoke to Abraham in verse 8, in Genesis chapter 22, verse 8. And Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went both of them together. Bible says God spoke, God tested Abraham, that took that only son of you, take that only son of you and go to that mountain and go and sacrifice that your son, my God. Let me tell you something. It's very painful that when you have only one, that you need to use it for a sacrifice. I said, build an altar for the Lord. My God. If you can build an altar for God, your life will never be the same. Bible says Abraham got to the mountain and he built an altar for God. And Bible said he laid his son on the altar and he took the knife to slay his son. But before that, Bible says Abraham, my God, he spoke a word to his son Isaac that the Lord shall provide. I say, if you build an altar, the Lord shall provide for you. In times of scarcity, in times of trouble, the Lord shall provide for you. Because God remembers his altar as a covenant between him and you. Build an altar of money. Build an altar of peace. Begin somebody. Feed somebody. Feed a widow. Build an altar for God. And Bible says he put an altar and mentioned the name, the Lord shall provide. And Bible says that because his word never failed, Bible says God spoke his word and said, Abraham, don't touch that boy, my God, for I have provided a sheep for you for a divine sacrifice. Let me tell you something. When you put an altar the Lord, when it reaches in times of scarcity, the Lord shall provide for you. Maybe whatever you are, your altar that you are building shall speak for you. The altar that you are building shall speak for your family. The altar that you are building shall speak for your children. Maybe you don't have anything. You used to use your own money, all your money for a divine sacrifice from the altar of the Lord. But let me tell you something. Let us build an altar of the Lord. Bible says in Joshua, in Exodus, Bible says Moses spoke a word. And he said, Lord, because you gave the Amalekite for me to slay them, Bible says Moses built an altar in John, in Exodus 17, and he built an altar and said, Jehovah Nissi, my God. If you can build an altar, God will come and dwell in there and will bring a blessing for you when times of need. God will sit to the altar that you are burdened. He will bless you. Let me tell you, my fellow brethren, one thing I want you to know. Let us build an altar for God. Many are building an altar for evil. He are building an altar for homes. They seek to the things of God. Many are building an altar in forest. But we shall remember the name of the Lord, and we shall build an altar for God. My fellow brethren, I want you to know and understand, build an altar for the Lord, and your life will never be the same. God will sit to it, because it's a divine intercession between you and your God, because there is a covenant that you build. Build an altar for the Lord. For your life be preserved, your family be preserved, your children be preserved over the dungeons of the enemy, so that the name of God be glorified. Bible said Job remember his children when Satan entered into heaven and he accused Job. He said there is an hedge around Job. If you can build an altar, there will be an hedge around you by the Spirit of God. Build an altar for Africa, and your life will never build the same. Build an altar for sacrifice, my God, and your life will never be the same. God bless you as you listen to the voice of Pastor Francis from Rehabia Kingdom Faith Ministry. God bless you. Amen.